Good morning. Hey, this is Ron Deering coming to you from my home office in Coeur d'Alene, Idaho. And this weekend, Eric Worre is doing his GoPro event in, I believe it's in Las Vegas, with speakers like Tony Robbins and I don't know if Branson's going to be there. I'm not sure. It's just an incredible, like 16,000 people there. And it got me thinking, and I have gone through his book GoPro, I don't know how many times, and so I put it on audio and started going through it again, and thought, "Hey, Justine," and thought, "You know what? I'm going to go through this another time. I won't say it would be my last time because it's such a great book." Laura, how are you doing this morning? And I'm going to do a series of eight live videos and eight blog posts. Just kind of talking about what's in there. Now, I am not going to go in the depth that he goes in. So if you have not got his book either on audio, Kindle, or the paperback, I've got them on all three. You need to pick up Eric Worre's GoPro book. It's an amazing book. And if you're in network marketing or home business at all, you need to get this book and go through it. But I wanted to kind of take a summary of an introduction and each of the seven skill sets that he talks about, and put this out there for people, just so you can kind of get an idea of where he's coming from, an idea of what it takes, and from pretty much nobody better. He's the best of the best. Two of my mentors in network marketing and MLM have been Eric Worre and Ray Higdon, and just Ray and Jessica Higdon both, and he's just been amazing. So, coming from someone that probably makes $30 or $40 million a year, teaching has been a millionaire in network marketing. He's not someone that's just writing about it. He knows how to build it, and is now spending his life teaching other people and training other people how to become network marketing professionals. He's one of these people that has taken the profession of network marketing to the level it should be. And the reason I say that is because when it first started back in the 50s with Amway, and I grew up in Amway country. Amway started in Grand Rapids area, Ada, Michigan. And it had a really bad rep. It was one of these things where if you got invited over to somebody's home, and this is exactly how I started. I was invited over to someone's home. And I was in the military at the time, and I was going over there under the premise of we're going to have some dinner and sit down and talk and chat and just, have a good night. And it turned out we got done. Hey, Charles, we got done having dinner, and the old easel and paper board showed up, and the circles began to begin to being drawn, and I was really taken back. Now, that said, when I saw it, it was my first introduction or exposure to network marketing, or back then it was MLM, multi-level marketing. And I was amazed. I thought, wow, here's a couple of things that I thought were just phenomenal compared to what I had been brought up. I'd been brought up in an era in the 50s and 60s that you go to school, go to college, get a degree, and you spend your lifetime working at a corporation for 40 years, then you retire, and then if you've got the health and the retirement was good enough, you do the things you really want to do. Okay. But I was finding that that wasn't really one of the things that was happening. There were a lot of people that were starting to already feel, even back in the 70s, the downsizing and so forth. So here I was introduced for the first time to a that allowed me to not only have my own business, very low income, startup cost, but was based on I was more successful. Hey, Bill Hoffman, amazing. I'm glad to see you here. Known Bill for many years in an old network marketing business that we did many years ago. But allow me to become successful based on how many people I helped become successful. Now, over the years, I grew up in the corporate world. After I got out of the military, after about 11 years, I went to work in a corporation, worked my way up to a vice president position, And I knew one thing. Corporate America was dog eat dog. You had to work hard, do better than everybody else, and it wasn't based on me helping anybody. It was based on me just being better than everybody else and hopefully, you know, beating out the guy that was up for the same job that I was. So when I first heard that there was a way that I could build a business, that I could become successful, and I could make a living helping other people become successful, and I would just get a little piece of what they made, I was amazed. I thought, wow, why isn't everybody doing this? You know? And when it first got introduced, there were a lot of people out there that took off. They went crazy. Friends, family, everybody that came into their circle, the 3 foot rule, was inundated and was attacked. And there were a lot of, you know, lawsuits at first because nobody understood what it was. There was a lot of bad reputations and there was a lot of negative publicity about MLMs and network marketing. And it was really because people didn't know what they were doing. They were just excited and wanting to build their businesses and thought they could do anything and everything they could. There are a lot of companies out there that were, you know, had no integrity and didn't build their business and their companies the right way and were illegal and scams and crooks and everything else. So it opened itself up to a lot of different things that became very, very negative. And one of the things that people like Eric Worre and Ray Higdon especially, and a lot of other people have done over the years, have taken the time, the energy, and made it their vision and mission in life to raise the level of what network marketing really is and to show people what the whole premise, what it's based on, what the concept and idea is that I get successful by helping more people get successful, which is something that's unheard of in corporate America. The whole idea is that, oh, it's a pyramid, and it, you know, it's the same old thing. If you think about it, corporate America is the biggest pyramid out there. Pyramid, what people think of as a pyramid is the guy on the top makes all the money. I would assure you that the company that you're working for right now, the guy's at the top and owns it, is making all the money, okay? And you may or may not have an option or a career path that will take you there. So, that said, Eric Worre has been one of the great pioneers in taking network marketing, the whole concept of this as a profession, to a whole new level. And I love that about him. So, today we're just going to talk kind of an introduction. What is network marketing? What is it all about? Okay, so first off, network marketing is exactly that. Networking and marketing, okay? And the cool thing about it is a lot of companies now are taking this business model because word of mouth has always been the best marketing out there. It's the best. It's the least expensive. I don't have to spend millions of dollars on Super Bowl ads or commercials and all these things. The best marketing that you can get is you put out a good movie. Thor just came out. And if your family members go to Thor, your friends go to see Thor at their theaters and come home and say, oh man, that was the best movie I've ever seen, and rave and rant about it, chances are you're going to see it. No matter how many commercials you see on TV and everything else, if someone you know that you trust and you know and you trust them and they come back and say, man, this is a great movie. If someone comes back and says, you know what, you can go see it, I just wait till it comes out on DVD or DirecTV or someplace, Netflix, because it really isn't that good and it wasn't really worth the time, then you're probably going to hold off. That's network marketing. The difference is that if I go out and I recommend a good restaurant, a good movie, a good book, a good just about anything, the publishers, the people that put that together get the money, okay? And all I get is the satisfaction of recommending something good to somebody. The nice thing about network marketing is if I recommend to you something, maybe I've got a travel business, maybe I'm in a technology, but maybe I'm in a health and wellness business. But if I recommend to you something that is great, that it works, that is nutritionally helpful, will change your life, now I can get the ability to be paid for that also. Okay? So that's what you're doing. You're networking and marketing, word of mouth, and the business model is that you get paid a little bit for everybody, every team that you build. Now, the other thing that most people don't understand, that there are a lot of professional businesses and business models out there that use this same model. Real estate. You look at a real estate company, there's the broker and all the agents. The broker gets a little bit of everything that the agents do, right? One big, Keller Williams is a real estate company, but it's a network marketing real estate company. So not only are the agents able to go out and sell properties and so forth, but they can bring in other agents and get a little bit of what those other agents do. Hey, Pam, how are you guys doing? And so the understanding exactly the power and the greatness of network marketing, most people just don't. Okay, so I've got a little list here of some of the benefits. It's a short list. Okay, maybe it's not a short list. It's a pretty good size list. But not having a boss, wouldn't that be great? Get up in the morning, you go to work, and the only boss you have is yourself. Now, that said, sometimes we're our own worst enemy, so us being the boss is not the next thing. No commute. I mean, when I get up in the morning, I go from, hey, Bill, how you doing, buddy? Bill is a good friend, and he is one of the newest members of our team and our business, and we've been friends for a long time. It's nice that when I get up in the morning, I come from upstairs to my home office downstairs upstairs, and that's my commute. I never have to worry about traffic, weather, or anything else. Okay, I haven't used an alarm clock in decades. No employees. If you've ever had your own business, like if you're in fast food, or I worked for a gentleman who I love dearly, who had has a franchise company. And I worked at the corporate office, and he had franchises all over the United States and a lot of employees. And employees can be good and they can be bad, but it's a headache. You've got to worry about payroll and all these other things, okay? You don't have to deal with politics. You don't have to, there are no compromises. This is your business. You build it the way you want, right? No dealing with discrimination. There's no discrimination in network marketing. Network marketing is great for whatever nationality you are, whatever education level you are, whatever gender you are. It doesn't matter. I know people that have no high school education and are making millions a year now because of the opportunity and what the network marketing profession allows them. Unlimited income, great products and services out there, no educational requirement, dealing with positive people. The one thing I love about the network marketing profession and that whole community is their positive outlook on everything. We get to enjoy the people we work with because we pick and choose who they are. You know, one of the biggest things with network marketing is the time freedom, residual income, the personal growth. People have always told me that network marketing is a personal growth, personal development with a business tied around it. Okay, it's an education of personal development with a business and income tied to it. Okay, lots of perks, international. Most of these companies allow you to contribute to a worthy cause, low risk, low startup costs, economic proof. You know, network marketing. There are more millionaires in the world that have become millionaires through network marketing than any other profession. Tax benefits are amazing. I very seldom pay hardly any taxes because of the benefits of having a home business. And the bottom line is it's fun. If you're someone that just hates people, it's certainly not going to be for you. If you're someone that loves people and loves helping people and loves teaching other people, my forte and my passion in life is I love teaching. I love taking the time to get in front of people and teach them and show them something new and a new way to do things. One of the biggest things out there right now is online marketing. And I love teach people how to blog, to set up their blog, to use Facebook and social media and so forth. I was honored that my blog was number 17 in the world for network marketing blogs. And it didn't come about because I didn't have mentors and people teaching me. Ray Higdon is an incredible blogger. He taught me pretty much everything I know about blogging. You know, I'm a techie. I know how to build a blog, but where do you go from there? And because I took the time to learn that, I get, you know, multitude of leads every day. I'm in contact with people every day, and my blog now was named number 17 in the world under people like Eric Worre and Ray Higdon and Lisa Torres and some of the giants in network marketing. So that's just some of the benefits, okay? And the last thing I want to talk about is the three different types of people that get into network marketing, okay? And then we'll cut this off for today, and tomorrow we'll go into the first skill level of prospecting, okay? So, first ones are posers, okay? Posers, treat this profession as a lottery ticket. They just go, they get in, and they just hope that something happens. They get lucky. They happen to walk down the street and run into somebody that is just dying to do network marketing, dying to be a part of their business, dying to be a part of their company. They love the product, and they go out and make them a millionaire. Okay, doesn't happen very often, if any. Okay, so they want to get make this business not a business, but they're using it as a hobby, and they're hoping to get the best out of the best with the least amount of effort as they can. Okay, those are the posers. Then you have the amateurs, and they've moved up a level, and they are focused on different things. Like they're out there working it, and they're hoping they're going to get that monster distributor that's going to take them to the next level. They are, you know, they're working on timing and the right placement, and hoping that they've got in at the right time, and they've been placed on the right team, and they in that team they're in the right position on that team, and they're just hoping. They're working, but they're hoping that all of these things have come together, and they're going to have the best of the best. The last is the professional, and I love Eric's definition of a network marketing professional, and I'm just going to read this to you. It's a person who is an expert in the skills required to build a large and successful network marketing organization, okay? And he talks about how ignorance on fire is better than knowledge on ice, and he believes, and I would agree with him, that that's more of a detriment in our industry and our profession, because you really need, if you had a doctor or a lawyer or an insurance salesman or another professional that you were working with, and they told you that they were excited, they haven't done all their homework and they haven't learned a lot, but they're very, very excited, you would probably not want to go to them. Okay, so we need to be a professional. We need to learn the skill sets. We need to become a expert in what we're doing. And that's what Eric and Ray and all of these professionals now are trying to do, is raise the elevation of what network marketing is and to create a organization and a profession of professionals, people that are professionals. So I hope this introduction, I hope if you are someone that is looking into network marketing, that you're sitting back going, wow, I didn't realize all these things. I didn't realize all these benefits. I didn't realize that the whole industry and profession was based on how many people I could help. How many people that I could help be successful would then make me successful. To me, that's just amazing. Now, I don't know of any other organization or any other profession other than maybe Christianity, the church, and serving our Lord, that has anything to do with other than ourselves. Build ourselves. Juan, how are you doing, buddy? Make sure that we are the ones that are getting the best of the best and the most of the most. And I think it was Zig Ziglar said, you can have anything in life you want if you show other people how to get what they want. How powerful is that? And to have a home business, to have a profession, to have a business model that is totally based on me becoming successful, based only on how many people I make successful and my own efforts and the efforts of others. So I hope this has given you some enthusiasm, some excitement about network marketing, and changed your mind a little bit about what it is. Stay tuned tomorrow. It may be tomorrow or the next day that I will be going into the part 2 of becoming a network marketing professional, and that's skill level number 1, prospecting. So you have a great day. Be sure to go to my blog at rondeering.com and check out the posts as they come up. And I can't wait to see you on my next live, which will probably be tomorrow or maybe even this afternoon. You have Valerie, great to see you. You have a great day. God bless. And we will see you on the next one.